Hello friends, I am Dr. Avilash Naik. I welcome all of you to this MOOC on Academic Counseling for ODL Learners. In this video, we shall discuss the role of assessors in the assessment of assignment responses. A distance teacher should thoroughly go through the self-learning materials before taking up the responsibility of evaluating the assignment responses. The distance teacher should compensate for the weaknesses in the lessons, units, and the assignments with appropriate grades and marks. Should try to break the isolation of the distance learners. Should sustain the motivation of the distance learners. Should evaluate the assignment responses and grade them appropriately. Should help the learners improve and advance their learning with purposeful comments. A teacher can do all these things if he or she is aware of the discrimination factors. The discrimination factors, they help the distance teacher discriminate between a weak response and a good one, a good response and a better one when they are favorable. They affect the judgment of the assessors when they are not favorable. Now let us see what are the discrimination factors which affect the assessment of the assignment responses. First of all, let us discuss assessor's perception of the unit. An assessor should have a thorough understanding of the relevant unit or units and try to discover what the course writers intend to convey through the unit. He or she should keep his or her reactions at bay while evaluating the assignment responses. Rather, he should see that what the learners are expected to achieve and should judge their performances accordingly. The next discrimination factor is assessor's perception of the assignment. An assessor might have a different understanding of a question in an assignment than it is expected. A faulty perception of a question in an assignment may lead to error in assessment. This problem can be avoided if there are clear-cut guidelines from the course writers and the assessors are properly trained before they are given the responsibility of evaluating the assignment responses. A proper understanding of the strengths and weaknesses of an assignment helps the assessor evaluate the assignment responses appropriately. The next discrimination factor is the tendencies towards being lenient or strict. Assessors or evaluators are considered to be lenient or strict if they deviate from the standard or norm score that is expected of the learners. Evaluators who are lenient while assessing or evaluating the answer scripts of one course may turn out to be very strict while evaluating the answer scripts of a different course. So we can conclude that no evaluators are absolutely strict or lenient. Now let us consider the next discrimination factor, that is the assessor's attention span. Efficient assessors, they stand apart from the inefficient assessors because of their attention span. Attention span refers to the ability of an assessor to evaluate an assignment within a specific period of time. Some evaluators, they may evaluate 2-3 assignment responses at one go, and some evaluators may evaluate 4-5 assignment responses at one go. Assessor's attention span reduces if they evaluate more student responses. For example, an evaluator with an attention span of 3 is likely to evaluate the 4th assignment response differently than it is expected. This will adversely affect the evaluation and the grading of the assignment response. As evaluators, academic counselors should avoid hurried casual and erratic evaluation to meet the deadlines. Now, the next discrimination factor that we shall be discussing is the assessor's ideal response. While preparing an assignment, the course writer or the course writing team should prepare an ideal assignment response which can serve as a model, norm or standard for the assessors or evaluators. This will help the uninitiated teachers to use the model, use the norm, use the standard to evaluate the responses appropriately. Not only that, this will also help the expert teachers to add their inputs and make the assessment authentic and judicious. Teachers can be trained, teachers can be oriented to prepare ideal responses for their courses before they are given the responsibility of evaluating the assignment responses. Besides these discrimination factors, there are a couple of other things that the assessors should keep in mind. First of all, record keeping. Record keeping is an essential activity for all the assessors or evaluators. The assessors or evaluators dealing with assignment responses should maintain a record of all the assignments they evaluate. This helps them in providing personalized comments to the learners on their progress and performance later, in avoiding unnecessary work, duplication of work, and third, in maintaining the records in accounts of the payments that they receive for evaluating the assignment responses. The next thing that they must keep in mind, that is the turnaround time. There should be a fixed time frame for receiving, processing, evaluating and giving the assignment responses back to the learners. And this time is called the turnaround time. Ideally, this time is 6 to 8 weeks. The evaluated responses should be given back to the learners well in time before the examinations so that they can go through the comments, identify the areas where they need to improve and prepare accordingly. Now, there are some ethical considerations that the assessors should keep in mind. What are they? First of all, the assessors should be acquainted with the distance education system thoroughly before they opt for evaluating the assignment responses. Second, they should be very careful and responsible while evaluating the assignment responses. They should ensure that the assignment evaluation work is objective, unbiased, and impartial. They should ensure that the grades or marks assigned to the learners reflect the real performance of the learners. They should avoid being too lenient or too strict and maintain a balance between the two. They should avoid harsh, harmful, and rude comments during the evaluation of assignment responses. They should give appropriate, supportive, and constructive feedback to the learners on all aspects of evaluation. And finally, they should return the assignments, evaluated assignment responses, to the learners well in time so that they can use the assignment responses for academic purposes. Thank you very much.